Hi everybody, it's me, Guy. I thought it would be fun to do a video where we recap all the craziness you saw in 2020 from the far left liberal progressive. So let's go ahead and get started. So early in the year, we had the World Health Organization working hand in glove with the Chinese Communist Party to cover up the Wuhan virus. We then had the mainstream media and Democrats calling the president xenophobic when he shut down travel from China, where the virus was coming from. Side note, he also shut down travel from Great Britain. We then were told that we only needed 14 days of shutdowns to stop the spread of this virus. Those 14 days of lockdowns, the draconian measures that you saw from a lot of blue state governors and unelected bureaucrats, well, that lasted a full 9 months. Literally thousands of businesses went over. You had a consolidation of wealth in big companies, a shift from small businesses. And even worse yet, you had millions of Americans that went unemployed or underemployed during that time. Then we went into the summer of love, as the Democrats like to call it, where the Democrats decided it would be a great idea to defund the police. We saw crime rates go up. We saw safety go down. Probably the worst policy decision that I've ever seen in my lifetime. And that gave us the CHAZ, the Autonomous Zone in Seattle. For anybody that often wonders, what would life be like if the far left liberal progressives took power all over the United States? Look no further. Stop your guessing. Just go back and study what happened in CHAZ. It's a glimpse into a future where it's run by liberal Democrats. Then we had Nancy Pelosi in the summer promising the American people she would give us relief by end of July. I know what you're thinking. I'm going to go to August for relief. Nope. September? Nope. You'll have to wait for it. Because in the fall, while we were waiting for Nancy Pelosi to give us relief, we had the media and big tech working in coordination to suppress a story about Joe Biden and Hunter Biden, his corruption. I, a congressman, was not allowed to share a tweet. The big tech tyrants stopped me. They refused to share, let me share a story from the New York Post. Side note, trivia fact, oldest newspaper in the United States, started by, another trivia point, Alexander Hamilton. Then, for those of you still waiting for when Nancy Pelosi gave relief, it was in December when she finally gave up her far left liberal demands of making sure illegal immigrants got stimulus checks, that blue state millionaires and billionaires got tax cuts, and the atrocious, horrible demand that we, the American people, bail out failed blue states that have had budgets that have been mismanaged for years. That's 2020 in review. If you want to follow me and keep informed into 2021, follow me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, Instagram. Have a happy and prosperous 2021.